As cars are becoming more complex, it's becoming more and more difficult to replace the factory ECU with a full aftermarket standalone ECU. And this is where products that allow the code or programming inside the factory ECU to be modified are becoming much more prominent and much more important. And we're here with Doug from Hondata, long-time supporter of the Honda brand, to talk about how that Hondata product works. So, Doug, your product has stretched a long way back in Honda's history. Yep. It's a product that I'm familiar with myself. And let's start with your older systems for the early OBD1 based ECUs.
Yes.
Now, in that sort of ECU, it wasn't possible to reprogram the ECU or reflash the ECU through the OBD2 plug or
no.
the diagnostics plug.
Yeah.
You actually had to modify the ECU itself?
Yes. The early computers ran with an EEPROM, which is a fairly standard piece of electronic equipment, which you could pull it out, reprogram, and put back in. But what we developed for that is a plug-in circuit board, which takes the place of the EEPROM with a USB adapter in the side of the ECU case, and we've turned it into a real-time programmable engine management system with lots of inputs and outputs, very similar to many aftermarket engine management systems you can buy.
Now, with that particular product, as well as your other products that are reflashable without modifying the ECU itself, you've had the option or the ability to add additional functionality. So I think this is one of the areas a lot of customers sort of may worry about with the option of reprogramming their factory ECU. Do you miss out on some of that functionality that you get with a full standalone, maybe boost control, maybe launch control, data logging, those sorts of things? How do you handle that with Hondata?
Well, obviously the stock computers don't have anything like boost control or launch control, so we leave all of the stock code in the computer. We don't change any of the OBD1 or OBD2 functionality, but we add features and functions that customers want. So boost control, we take control of one of the purge control outputs of the computer and connect that to a boost control solenoid. So we have, as a result of adding the software and the hardware output, boost by gear and boost by RPM, and the ability, of course, to do bigger injectors, which any engine management system can do, but also the ability to handle things like nitrous, alcohol, ethanol, and ethanol content sensor inputs. So it has the functionality of a lot of many higher priced engine management systems, but starting off with your stock computer, which comes with your vehicle.
So in terms of the Hondata product, it becomes a very cost-effective way of reprogramming the ECU?
Oh, absolutely. We find that if we look at the entirety of the tuning community and what people do, the Hondata products suit probably 95 to about 97% of what your customers want to do. And for those customers who need the more inputs and more outputs that the stock computer doesn't provide, there are plenty of aftermarket engine management systems which have got that higher level of functionality. But the one big advantage of our products working with the Honda ECUs is they were designed to run these engines in the first place. And as I tell a lot of people, Honda has spent more money on R&D just getting their Hondas to start and idle than most people have spent on designing their entire engine management systems.
Yeah, I think that's an aspect that is often overlooked. You've got an ECU that is designed from the outset to run one specific engine and do the best job possible of running that engine, compared to a universal standalone aftermarket ECU that's obviously designed to be able to be fitted and onto and run just about any of thousands of different engines. So obviously that makes sense. So where would you say the limitations, if there are any, would lie with this sort of system where you are basing your control around that Honda ECU? Are there limitations?
There are limitations, and more for inputs and outputs. The stock Honda engine computers, when they designed the circuit boards, don't have analog inputs and digital and analog outputs or controls for controlling external devices. And that's because Honda have not designed their ECUs to interface with that sort of hardware. And that's probably the biggest limitation. It's for inputs and outputs from the stock engine computer, which in an aftermarket system, those are generic. You can customize and tailor that. But to a point, we've got, for example, in our OBD1 S300 and our K-Pro systems, we've got 8 analog inputs, which we can feed in through our circuit board. But for the reflash only computers, which is from 2006 onwards, we never open up the computer. Everything is done through the OBD2 port.
Now, let's move on to those 2006 onwards ECUs. So now, as you've said, you don't need to modify or add that daughter board onto the factory ECU. Everything can be changed via that OBD2 port. So how much easier for you has that made the process of modifying the factory tuning?
Well, one of the things from a business standpoint is that the computer never needs to come to us. We just send out our flash for a programming device. The customer doesn't even have to need to know where the computer is. And it's been quite funny. In some of the early days when we've been receiving ECUs from people to update, they've sent steering columns, anti-lock brake computers. They've sent all sorts of things because they haven't been able to sort of find out and know where the computer is. So it's made it easier for the customer. They just find their OBD2 port, plug in, make any program changes that they want, and then upload it within 5 minutes is typically all it takes.
Now, in terms of the factory ECU as well, as the cars have become more complex, the communications between that factory ECU and all of the other electronic modules in the car has become much more prominent, particularly with CAN communications.
Yeah.
And that's also made it much more difficult to remove that factory ECU and replace it with a standalone. So retaining the factory ECU, that means that everything else in the car still works as Honda intended?
That's correct, and your vehicle these days is a rolling chassis of computers, just computer systems for everything, and the data that it's flowing between all those computer systems is really there's quite a lot of it. So we knew from the standpoint of our business is that there's no way we could make our own standalone computer system and have it work with the same degree of sophistication and reliability that a manufacturer could to communicate with all the other systems. So we just work with whatever Honda has provided us, and we're standing on the shoulders of giants here. So any changes that we make, we just deal specifically with the engine tuning. We don't alter anything on the other safety aspects of the vehicle for anti-lock braking, and we don't interfere with any of that communication. That just works exactly as the manufacturer had intended.
Now, when it comes to a new model from Honda, they're bringing out a new car, for example. You've been working with Honda brand for a very long time. From your perspective, when a new model comes out, do you get any support from Honda, or are you just having to start from scratch and reverse engineer what's inside that ECU?
Well, support from Honda, I'll get onto that in a little bit, but we have developed everything from scratch. We'll take the computer, we'll read the information out, we'll analyze it, have a look at it, and if necessary, we will rewrite and add the code that we need to add. Honda is a Japanese company, and we get probably a phone call every week or two from Honda employees who are saying, I have this kind of Honda for myself, what can you do for me? So it's the engineers from within Honda who are the enthusiasts who they want to put their cars on the racetrack and they want to do performance stuff with them. And it's been very heartening for us that over the last 12 months with the introduction of the new turbo Honda Civic here, we've had feedback from Honda is that they want to see their vehicles on the drag strip now. They want to see them on the circuit racing. They want to see their vehicles being used by enthusiasts. So Honda themselves now have a performance-based vehicle, and they want to see it being used as it should be. So back to your earlier question, do we get any advance information? No, we basically figure it out all ourselves.
It sounds like the hard way of doing it, but obviously you're definitely getting there with it. Now, one other aspect with using that factory ECU that is becoming more and more critical, particularly here in the US market, where emissions compliance is so critical. We're seeing that also spread around the rest of the world. With an aftermarket standalone ECU, it can, in some instances, be difficult, in some instances, even impossible to achieve emissions compliance. Whereas, provided you have an engine that's mechanically capable of being emissions compliant, retaining that factory ECU, a catalytic converter, etc., emissions compliance is not a problem.
It's not a problem if it's done correctly. Now, funnily, when you look inside the code for the engine computer, the actual code you need to run the engine itself is pretty minimal. About 80% of the computer code is associated with emissions compliance, monitoring sensors, is everything within spec. So we worked with the California Air Resources Board to develop a carb specific flash pro, and we have taken our vehicles and our performance programs to the laboratory, and we've run the same emissions test that Honda has had to do when they have passed their emissions calibrations for their vehicles. And it's a tough test. It's 25 minutes on a dyno, a small roller dyno, running through a road course of loads and speeds, quite hard acceleration, where all of the gases from your exhaust pipe are gathered and analyzed to make sure that it does not exceed manufacturer or emissions level specifications that the US government sets. So I'd like to think that having passed the emissions tests for the California, state of California, we should have no problem passing emissions tests for any other country in the world.
Well, it's definitely an important aspect, and as time goes on, obviously the focus on emissions is only going to become more critical, again making it harder for a lot in the aftermarket with standalone ECUs to make cars road legal. Thanks Doug for your time there, and thanks for giving us some insight into the Hondata brand. Now if our viewers want to find out more, how can they get in touch?
Well, obviously the internet's the easiest way, and Hondata.com on the internet, and we've got all of our contact details there, and we've got information on all of the vehicles that we do performance for. And the nice thing about the new Civic that's just come out is it's a world vehicle, and it's we're traveling to a lot of countries, and we're setting up a lot of distributors in different countries, and there are a lot of enthusiasts everywhere really excited to see the performance potential of the new Hondas coming out.
Definitely we're excited to see where that product goes in the next few years as people get stuck in to modify it. Thanks again for your time, Doug.
Thanks, Andre.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask questions, which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.